Can we go? I can't wait to meet this monstrous beauty.
Her beauty's killed several men.
Now you tell me.
Like my friend Dandelion says, we all have to die of something. I'll have my eye on you at all times.
So will she.
Don't let her kiss you.
I don't usually deny women foreplay, but I'll do my best.
Let's do this.
Well, how should we begin? If our bodies could a song compose, my heart would inquire of your hands pale and fine, if they'd grasp it gently to hold like a rose, or treat it as a morsel upon which to dine.
Who are you, gorgeous one?
I'm a poet, m'lady. I've come to praise your unearthly beauty, if you'll do me the honor of revealing your full self.
Indeed. I shall reveal to you all my splendors. Prepare more than your eyes. I am a feast for all the senses. Come with me for the adventure of your life.
I should get Geralt. On the other hand, I've never plowed a succubus.
I am so unsatisfied. Lovers who compose poems praising my virtues. Delightful. But I've never had a true poet perform for me.
Fucking idiot actually went in. I got him into this mess. I'd better get the fool out.
I don't remember inviting you, Geralt of Rivia.
Let Dandelion go.
You mean you won't join us? He's come to no harm. On the contrary, he seems very happy.
Like all the other men you murdered?
I've murdered no one. All who followed me experienced unearthly pleasures.
You devour their energy like a swine gobbles spuds.
I need their vital energies. I have no use for corpses.
What will you do with Dandelion?
I shall show you my intentions are pure. I'll release him when he wakes.
So if it wasn't you, who killed those young men?
I can seduce anyone and hold them spellbound for as long as I wish. Unfortunately, one fool fell madly in love with me. Unable to accept my nature, he's killing my lovers.
Who is this lover of yours?
A beautiful elf named Elias.
He asked me to investigate the murders.
His way of throwing you off his scent. Luckily, you're no fool.
The very reason I think you're trying to throw me off your scent.
Did he show you the victims' bodies?
He told me they were buried.
By him. Yet he massacred the corpses first to make it seem as if beasts had attacked the poor souls. I'm content to have you looking into the matter. Just be sure to see it through.
Why should I help you?
I want men to know that I give pleasure in return for their energy. But I don't take their lives. Besides, I can give you something far better than Orence.
I'll talk to him, then I'll come back.
I hope we can seal our friendship then.
I found the succubus.
Did you kill her?
She claims you're the murderer.
You were supposed to kill the monster, not chat with it.
I know what I'm supposed to do.
I don't think so, not if you believed her.
You lied to me. You knew a succubus had made its lair in the burned-down village.
I did. I thought you'd refuse to help me if I told you.
You're right. I don't help murderers.
That is pure nonsense. I killed no one.
Liar. You fell in love with her and murdered your competitors. Succubi aren't exactly the most faithful partners.
True, I love her, but the rest is hogwash.
If I'd killed the succubus, no more men would have perished and you'd have gotten away with it.
You don't understand. She manipulated me like she's manipulating you.
Yorvith will learn of this. You'll hang for your crimes.
You're mad. I'm innocent.
Don't try anything.
I don't like you, Witcher.
The leader, though clad like a soldier, had a feminine face to stir.
Greetings, Gwynblade.
Your Scoia'tael, Elias, is murdering people from Vergen.
Any proof? Elias is one of my best warriors.
I found a splinter from a blade in one of the bodies. Compare it to Elias's weapons.
I'll see to it. Elias must have learned that I know the truth about his madness. He's fled the city.
Virgin of Edda, behold her, insurgent leader.
I'll not be put down like some dog! Fight!
Come on!
I'm pleased you put an end to that fool's torment. You'll be blissfully rewarded. Disrobe and relax. In the box by the bed, I left you a small gift. Something to remember me by. Goodbye, Witcher.
What is it, Witcher?
Who is that girl?
Cynthia, a leashed sorceress.
A charming expression. Do you also use muzzles?
Leash means a connection between a sorceress and her assistant. An unfortunate term, I admit, but it explains how things are. Cynthia can tap my power, use my spells. She's a conduit. And she's learning along the way. It's convenient, and except for the name, not derisive at all. But you're not here to talk about Cynthia.
Have you heard about a Witcher's school? Apparently the Viper's their sign.
No. Why do you ask?
The Kingslayer wears a medallion adorned with a Viper.
Pretentious and childish for my taste. He can't be very smart.
A sorceress like you ought to know bundles about the Wild Hunt.
A sorceress's knowledge has nothing to do with superstitions.
The Hunt's not a superstition.
True. The phenomenon seems to exist.
I want to know everything there is to know about it.
It's strictly atmospheric. It doesn't interest me. Just as whirlwinds, whirlpools, and snowfalls do not interest me.
There's proof that the Wild Hunt is a vast accumulation of the power. Something that would interest mages, you'd think.
To the mere mortal, anything that is not immediately comprehensible is suspect, the product of a conspiracy. And where there's a conspiracy, well, it's obvious mages must have hatched it.
I'm a mortal, though probably not a mere one. I found the notes of a man who spent his entire life...
Paranormal phenomena interests Cynthia, my, intern. Take this up with her.
Is what they say true? Did Saskia kill a dragon?
Prince Stennis decorated her for it at the court in Vengerberg, so it appears to be true. If you want to know the details, talk to Biggerhorn. Apparently he witnessed it.
How is it that King Radovid's court sorceress and advisor is supporting rebellion in Edirne?
This has grown into more than a simple rebellion, Witcher. Prince Stennis's arrival here confirmed Saskia's right to represent Edirne.
Saskia isn't fighting for Edirne, but for the Pontar Valley. Even Prince Stennis considers you rebels. He hasn't moved against you because war with Kedwin hangs by a thread. Why are you here, Sorceress of Tretagor?
It is my duty. If Henselt occupies the Pontar Valley, Redania and Temeria will respond strongly. The North will disintegrate, its unity gone. A dark scenario that is nevertheless avoidable, provided Saskia is successful and wins the Valley's independence.
Even if she thwarts Henselt, there'll be no independence without agreement from Redania and Temeria.
Temeria's expansionist plans melted away with Foltest's death. Redania's ruler is unpredictable, but even he'll have to respect a victory. I'm here to make this victory a fact.
I found an immortelle.
Excellent. You wanted to discuss...
You said we'd need a magical object to cure Saskia. Any ideas where I might start looking?
Magical items do not grow on trees, as you know. Luckily, this area has a long history. There's the Battle of Wraiths, the site of Sabrina Glevesig's death and suffering, the abandoned mines.
I was hoping you'd be specific.
I won't ask you to traipse around with a divining rod, but please try to be a little inventive. Ask the locals, that's always a good place to start. I dare say Alderman Burden knows every last stone in the area. Maybe you should see him. You wanted to dis...
I'm looking for Triss. Letho forced her to teleport near Vergen.
Letho?
Foltest's killer. Perhaps Demoven's too. Will you help me find her?
Certainly. We sorceresses must stick together. We have too many enemies.
Triss contacted you through Sheila de Tanzerville's megascope while in Flotsam.
And I haven't heard from her since.
Can you locate her?
A megascope responds to a person's aura. If I had something of hers, I could find her. You were close to her. Maybe you have something.
No, I don't have anything.
Not good. Wait. A local drunkard claims he saw a redhead fall out of the sky. This could be a lead.
I never heard of flying women before.
Perhaps they're just drunken delusions. It's possible, however, that an unstable teleport ejected Triss near the town.
As it's our only lead, I'll talk to this drunkard. Do you know him?
I'm not used to associating with drunkards, but you'll likely find him in the inn.
Thank you.
Come back as soon as you learn anything.
Let me tell you about the woman who fell
Look,
from the sky.
Another one. You let one human
told that story a thousand times. I've heard enough of flying women.
I heard you saw something interesting.
As clearly as I see you. Amazing. I look into the sky. But wait. You must buy a fellow a drink for such a story.
Well, you shut it already. We can all recite this bullshit now.
I'm a client and I'll say what I want. Pour me some Mahakaman mead and no cheating. This noble wayfarer will pay.
I'll pay, but if you bore me, I'll shove this meat up your ass.
It's such a fine liquor. And my ass has no taste. You won't regret it.
Speak.
Last week I was passing by the gullies. I like to take a hike from time to time.
Get to the point.
Hush. So I'm walking and suddenly there's a flash, a crack. I'm thinking, a storm's coming, but nearly a cloud in the sky.
You hit the ground with your arse so hard you saw a flash. You were that drunk.
Then I saw people lying in a gully as if they'd fallen from the sky, a man and a woman. The woman was so beautiful, I wished she'd fallen down on me.
What did the woman look like?
A redhead. Wearing a vest and high shoes, with pert tits and a round arse. Just waiting to be grabbed and...
Sounds just like your old lady.
Shut your mouth!
What happened then?
Well, the woman was hurting, couldn't get up. The man clearly disliked her, because he didn't help her. He just stood there, menacing and talking. And then he left, and the redhead stayed.
Noticed her tits? I didn't even try to help her, you sod.
I was about to do exactly that when a troll came out of the gully, ugly as shit after blueberries.
Did it attack her?
Not at all. I hid and saw everything. First he sniffed her, so I thought he'd eat her. But he didn't. He threw her over his shoulder like a sack and returned to the gullies.
Is that all?
Yes. Didn't waste your money, as you'll agree.
I heard a human with the power to sit astride a man's pants with their bellies to puff up.
How can I help you?
I'm looking for places steeped in magic. You remember any stories of sorcerers or magical places in the area?
Not counting the fire-spitting bitch from 3 years ago. Well, a sorcerer once lived in the wood beyond Vergen. You could look there. Maybe something's left. You might also speak to Cecil. Nobody knows Vergen's history as well as our aldermen.
He travels the world, killing monsters for all the witches.
He's got those glistening eyes.
The sorcerers mutated him when he was young.
Things this world has to bear.
She's wounded. Let her bleed.
Better lunge at her all at once. She's weakened.
Not worth the risk.
What are you doing here?
We're mercenaries. Currently on King Hansel's pay. We were sent here on reconnaissance. Barely escaped with our lives from that mist of specters. Now we're up against a furious she-troll. Who are you?
Geralt of Rivia.
The White Wolf. We could use professional help, Witcher.
Will you help us?
I can't let you kill her.
Since when does a monster slayer take their side?
None of your business. I need her, and you need to leave.
She killed two of my men.
Walk away, and nobody else will get hurt.
You won't help? Fine. Just don't disturb us. We'll manage ourselves.
The troll needs to live.
The troll will die.
Then you'll have to kill me, too.
In that case, adieu, Witcher.
Enough! We surrender! Throw down your arms, men! Spare us, Witcher. The king will pay our ransom.
I'm not looking for a ransom. Leave the troll alone and go your way.
You'll let us go?
You can't return through the mist. It's certain death.
The soldiers of fortune. We're not afraid of death.
Neither do we foolishly seek it. The Witcher's right.
Commander, we were to find a Witcher.
A bald one with a snake medallion. This one's white-haired, with a wolf on his neck.
You're looking for Letho.
You know him?
You could say that. I'm looking for him too. What do you know about him?
Sheila de Tanzerville told us to search the ravines for this Letho. All we found was a camp strewn with dead Scoia'tael. This Letho was responsible for the bloodbath. And he did not act alone.
Where was this?
On the other side of the Wraith's Mist.
What were you to do with him?
Kill him. And anyone with him.
Anyone? Are you sure?
That was the order.
Do you know where Letho is?
Somewhere on the other side of this mist. We found a trail, but then the mist descended. We got lost, and emerged from it here.
I advise you to surrender to the rebels.
That would be new to me. I am Adam Pangrat, known as a Dieu.
You won't survive for long out here.
They'll hang us. They know Ensel hired us.
Go to Cecil Burden. He'll treat you fairly.
But don't count on him outbidding Henselt.
Hear that, boys? Let's meet the Dragon Slayer. The Witcher claims we'll be safe and sound. Gather the wounded. Stop buggering and move out.
Hjumi's troll, see? To kill Hjumi's Ichi. Would kill trolls, sure. You, other. Good, you help. Troll, you help.
If you want to help me, go back to your old man.
No! Idiot Hjumi redhead grope.
He's alone now. He misses you.
Tell him! Too late!
Return to your husband if you want to repay me.
Troll don't want, but troll will. For you other, you good.
Mrs. Back! Good! Troll-like!
Me back for Wisha asked! Stay away if we shall not ask.
Mrs. Wise!
Idiot you, Hjumi woman grope.
No more, never again.
Give me the bandana.
Here, stupid old buck.
Troll give horn. In danger, Wisher blow, troll come.
Thanks, I'll remember that. Now go to your mate.
Maybe pick her some flowers first.
Flowers? No! Flowers stench. Troll bring bird dung.
Eject! What troll doing lair?
Nothing.
Knee-see! Stench!
The stench will run. Go!
Cue me, stench! Sleep no me!
More harpy feathers, just like you wanted.
Good work! Why, it's even a pleasure to pay you!
I gotta admit, that might have been the strangest job I've ever had.
Well, it's hardly done.
I'll hear you out, but I've got a bad feeling about this.
I need a few more feathers.
Who is it that needs them? You or this collector?
But he does, of course!
Pretty suspicious. Why didn't you tell me how many I was supposed to bring right off?
I needed to see the quality. Just a few feathers more. I'll pay extra. Decide.
Let me think about it. Got some more feathers. Sleek and untattered. I hope that'll do it.
I'll look at them and select the finest. There's your payment, with a small bonus.
What am I supposed to do with the ones I have left?
Whatever you wish. I've no need for them. Farewell. At your service. You're beautiful, my queen, my lady. You're a wonder sight. All in your nest envy you.
Hope I'm not interrupting. I want you to have this feather. I have no use for it.
No, thank you. Neither do I.
Neither does this collector, you mean?
Yes. Neither does he.
I wonder why he needed a specific number of feathers.
Perhaps to match the number of empty spaces in his feather album.
Don't see how that would matter.
It's immensely important!
Well, I guess I don't know much about collections. Pretty warm for this time of year.
It is colder usually, isn't it?
The mages must be up to something.
Oh, yes. They devise with experiments. Always changing the world. They'll botch it one day, and it'll be the end of us, I tell you.
I shudder to even think about it.